गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द लेक्चर नंबर 8 एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द डिवीजन एंजियोस्पर्म एंड दिस इज द लास्ट डिवीजन ऑफ द किंगडम प्लांटिंग. व्हाट इज द कॉमन आर यू कैन से दैट मेन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द मेंबर्स ऑफ this division. First of all, going to know what is the term angiosperm means. Students, the term angiosperm is also derived from the Greek word angio, that means concealed or married, and in general way you can also use the term covered. What covered encloses, like the terms you can used on the place of concealed or married. Is that clear? And sperma means seed. It means, students, the division angiosperms includes the varieties of plants in which the members produces the seeds which are covered inside seed coat and present inside the fruit. This makes that differ from the gymnosperms, because what we study in gymnosperms, you all of you study the gymno means net and sperma means seed. It means the gymnosperms includes the varieties of plants which first never bears flower, and second the seeds are never covered inside the seed coat. But in this division, all the plants are flowering plants. They just bear the seeds, and the seeds are enclosed inside the seed coat and almost present at the central part of the fruiting body or fruit. It means the development of fruit take place in all the angiosperm plants. Is that clear? Now going to discuss about the some general characteristics. Students, exceptionally angiosperm is also, after the pteridophytes, the large division of kingdom plant. But exceptionally, because in our surrounding the most of the species are found belonging to the division angiosperm, so we can call it means lots of examples are available in our surrounding regions. That's why we can exceptionally say the division angiosperm is the common largest division or is group of species of kingdom planting. Member plants or trees are well differentiated into root and shoot system, and they are the well developed vascular plants. The vascular system, it means the xylem and the phloem, are well developed in position in the angiosperm. All the member plants produces flowers. It means they are just flowering plants. They produces seeds, and seeds are enclosed inside the fruiting body. As well as seeds also have a covering part that is called seed. The angiosperms seeds contain one or more seed leaves, and seed leaves are also called cotyledon. What? Cotyledon. The term cotyledon means seed leaf. What? Seed leaf. As you examine, when a paddy seed is uncovered, it means its corm is separated, then you find only a single seed leaf. But when you uncover a groundnut, a gram or a pea, and remove their seed coat, you observe that after peeling the seed coat or after removing the seed coat, the seed is divided into two half lobes. These half lobes are the two seed leaves are cotyledon. That's why ahead you all of you study the division angiosperm is further classified into two subclasses, the class monocotyledon, and or you can also call them monocot, and dicotyledon or dicot. Is that clear? On the basis of presence of number of seed leaves in their seed, they are just classified into two subclasses. Now students, angiosperms includes large ranges of plants, from the smallest plant, the world's smallest plant, Fulvia, to the tall tree, Eucalyptus. Students, you can take the screenshot of these general characteristics. He will just return in 2 seconds. Thus, students, the eucalyptus is of about 20 to 30 feet in height. This is the tallest member of the division angiosperm, and they provide us food, fodder to our animals, fuel as cooking purposes and other purposes, as well as they also provide us timber plant that are useful in making houses. Many medicinal plants are also included, like cinchona, basil, clove, and lots of spices are also included in this division. Several other commercially important products are also we obtain from the member plants of division angiosperm. The member plants shows double fertilization. What? It means the process of fusion of gamete take place two times. That is called double fertilization. So students, this is the very peculiar characteristic of the member plants to show double or triple fertilization. Their life cycle is diplontic type. Their life cycle is diplontic type. It means their predominant phase is diplontic, and as well as their mature phase is also diplontic, because they bear uni or bisexual flowers. Unisexual or bisexual flowers. And what are flowers? As I was explain you that the flowers are just the sexual reproductive organ of the flowering plants. Is that clear? So in dioecious plants, the male and female flowers are different. That's why called unisexual flower. Is that clear? When the male flower and female flower both are different, as you all of you notice in jackfruit, in papaya, are the best example to define the unisexual plants and the flowering in them. Now, in bisexual, the male and female, both reproductive part are present in a same flower or in a single flower. Is that clear? So called bisexual flower. And there are lots of examples in your surrounding areas of the bisexual flower. Hibiscus, marigold, rose, jasmine, the lotus, water lily, water hyacinth. These are just the example of bisexual flowers. Is that clear? The male part of the flower, or male reproductive part of the flower, is called stamen. What called? Stamen. And students, the stamen is just consist of two main parts, a filamentous part and a bilobed or a triad part, that is called anther. What? Anther. The filament and anther are connected by connective tissue. Is that clear? This is just a male reproductive part, that is stamen, or you can call it male reproductive part. This is the filament and this is the anther. What? Anther, and this is the filament. Is that clear? Now the female reproductive part is called pistil, carpel or gynoecium. The stamen is also called androecium. When lots of stamens are present in a single flower, their group is called androecium. What? Androecium. Likewise, this is also called androecium. Is that clear? Likewise, the female reproductive part is also called gynoecium. What? Gynoecium. Pistil and carpel are the singular name to represent a single female reproductive part. Like to the anther or like to the stamen, the pistil or carpel is also consist of following three parts. What are they? The stigma is the uppermost or topmost part. Next to the stigma, the style. And the next is the ovary. What? Ovary. And the structure of a female reproductive part of the flower is just like a round bottom clasp having a long neck. Understood? This is the stigma part, students. Stigma, and this is the style, and this part is the ovary, and it contains number of rounded transparent structures in premature stage. Each are called ovules. What called? Ovules. These are eggs are ovules. A single is called egg or ova, and its group is called ovules. And these are the female gametes. What is, friends? Just they are female gametes. The presence of number of ovules helps in the angiosperm to perform the process of multiple fertilization. Yes, students, they can multiply fertilize to form more number of seeds in a single fruiting body. If a single seed is formed, then it is called single fertilization. More than one seed is formed inside the fruit, called double fertilization. Three, then called triple fertilization. And if many seeds are formed, just like the papaya, guava, apple, then this is called pomegranate. Then this is called the multiple fertilization. Is that clear? So students, but double fertilization is most common in most of the angiosperms. After that, the multiple fertilization is also accompanied by the angiosperm members. That is, so students, the female reproductive part is the gynoecium, and it has following three parts: the style, this is the uppermost flattened part, which is also called receptacle because it receives the male gamete that is transferred from anther to the stigma of the flower. Okay, we will discuss in more detail about the process of reproduction in flowering plants, but here we are just going to introduce about the structure of the male and female reproductive parts in our flower. Is that clear? Now students, the process of fusion, as here we will discuss about the double fertilization. So the process of fusion occurs two times, in a primary endonucleate nucleus, or you can say that primary endosperm mother nucleus, that is called PEM, and the primary endosperm nucleus is called PEM. In a primitive form you can call it PEM. Hence the double fertilization takes place, or it is called double fertilization because the primary endosperm nucleus is triploid, in which a secondary nucleus is present with the antipodal and synergized cells in a ovule, and two, you can say that haploid nuclei fertilize the secondary nucleus to fertilize the process, or you can say that the process of fertilization takes place two times. Once from the primary endosperm nucleus, and once fuses with the primary nucleus, and again it fuses with the secondary nucleus. Thus, two times fertilization takes place in a single event. That's why this is very commonly called secondary or double fertilization. Secondary method of fertilization or double fertilization. We will also discuss about the process of fertilization in division angiosperm separately with a special lecture, in which we only discuss about the flower, their parts, and how the process of double fertilization takes place in angiosperm. Now students, going to take some example of angiosperm. Then wheat, rice, maize, gram, pea, mustard, bean, beside them the groundnut, sunflower, sugar cane, jowar, bajra, lots of examples you can obtain from your surrounding regions and from the cultivated farmlands. These are just the members of division angiosperm. Thanks students for joining today's lecture. In next video lecture we are going to discuss about the classification of the division angiosperm. It means the monocot or monocotyledon and dicot or dicotyledons. Thanks students.